So I made the mistake of sending Deidre Imus an email a minute ago. Because I didn't have her pack any lunch for me because I'm sick.
Yes.
But I feel better, a lot better.
Yeah.
So I said, what can I have that's available here to eat? Well, rather than answer that question, here's what she does.
Okay.
Here's what she writes back. You told me you didn't want a sandwich and radishes or wood. Going. You either want me to pack your lunch or you don't. So right away, taking an aggressive attitude, wouldn't you think?
Yeah, that is aggressive. Yes.
There's nothing to eat there unless you find some organic raw vegetables, millet bread, or oatmeal. I've already been offered oatmeal, but it wouldn't be organic oatmeal, so.
Right. Be processed.
I mean, but.
Somehow.
She and Cavuto should get married.
That's all.
You know, those two bastards live with each other. I mean, he's so I'm starving to death.
It's a little abrupt. Yes,
isn't it? Yeah,
just a little bit.
I don't. I mean, when it was time to make the decision about the lunch was last night, when I felt horrible. Well, I got up this morning and I felt a lot better.
Yeah,
so I changed my mind. But I don't need to be, you know,
castigated by,
by the Ayatollah for you either want lunch or you don't. Well, who needs that attitude?
Well, of course, look who she has to live with.
Time to rotate that one out.
Good morning, Bernie.
Good morning, Chief. Well, actor Wesley Snipes has got to go to jail next week for 3 years for not paying taxes, for not even filing his income tax returns. For 3 years.
But wasn't he involved in some religious deal or something, wasn't it?
It was some wacky
scam. Some deal like the Universal Life Church deal, which I'm a minister of, but I've never tried to pull a tax scam.
No.
So, whatever, go ahead.
Well, he's not going to get away with it. 3 years. It's going to be a blue Christmas for Wesley Snipes next week.
Wow.
And Willie Nelson right now is wiping his forehead saying, damn, that was close. And two Oklahoma women, Chief, two Oklahoma women were arrested trying to shoplift at a TJ Maxx. They were big fat women. They were hiding stuff under their belly fat, their armpit fat, their breast fat. You know, if you can imagine like Joy Behar sticking a sandwich under her big flabby arms or something like that. They were busted. One woman had three boots under her breasts. It sounds like right out of Dagan's family.
It sounds like it was her family. Yeah. Sounds like Dagan's family Christmas shopping. Doesn't it, Dagan?
What was her last name?
Anyway, what else, P?
And, well, that's it right now.
It is?
That's all I have, yeah.
Well,
you know what happened? You remember yesterday?
Angry because Dagan and I interrupted you, are you?
Not in the least. No, no,
okay.
No.
Okay. What happened?
Just quickly, remember yesterday I told you about the Christmas tree lighting where they had that disaster with the 80s singing group Boys to Morons?
Yeah.
Lip syncing? Well, also they had Jeff Zucker. I mentioned this late in the program. Jeff Zucker and Mayor Bloomberg lighting the Christmas tree, and Jeff Zucker with his shirt unbuttoned almost down to his navel, scaring the hell out of kids and making adults throw up. It was very inappropriate. And he's like the geek who stole Christmas over there at the Christmas tree lighting. And also, at the very end, Al Roker started to look like he started to make out with that sweet chili pie, Natalie Morales, and then all of a sudden they cut away. So it was just an utter disaster at the NBC Christmas tree lighting. It was just very, very inappropriate behavior and technical glitches, and it was just awful.
Repulsive. Oh, God. This poor Sam is sponsored by Robotic Urology. It's time for Dagan McDowell and her business report. Now, good morning, Dagan.
Good morning, sir. Here's another crime story. This is my favorite crime story of the day. A worker, an office worker at Memorial Sloan Kettering Hospital, was accused of stealing $3.8 million from the hospital solely by ordering toner cartridges from Office Depot and then selling them on the black market. His name's Marquis Gums. He earned only $37,000 a year, but owned a Trump apartment out in New Rochelle, was driving an X6 BMW, shopping at Gucci and Louis Vuitton. This went on over a number of years, but he was ordering them from Office Depot and then telling the delivery men to meet him in the street. And he was loading them into God knows what.
I need a ton of cartridges. I have a Hewlett Packard printer at home. I was printing out some sheet music for Wyatt, and I could use him. Just
that was
think
a
of that,
terrific know. Segue. Yeah. Thank you. For driving this bus into a very muddy ditch.
Charles just goes,
interesting, I mean.
Fascinating.
terrific.
What else? Anything?
You just quit printing?
Oh, hell.
Oh, but it's the
now I lost light, my train of thought, light. And I'm thinking about that. Your hair.
Yeah, okay.
You know how you avoid having a bad hair day? Have none, so be thankful.
32. So somebody said, how do you operate a cattle ranch?
Right.
If you're with cattle, if you're a vegetarian, well, we raise Texas longhorns, and generally you don't eat them. So
that would be the way that works.
That would be. But don't worry about it. It's a working cattle ranch for kids with cancer, which seems to be a point more on face that you missed. Jesus, God. What are you doing? Going to the Hamptons every summer?
Yeah.
That's what you're doing with your life. So.
Good idea to send that email.
Dopes. Diggin's sister Megan is here. How are you?
Morning, sir.
What?
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Is that Bernard McGurk married?
Yes, he is.
Because he is B-A-L-D smoking. I well, love me a man who looks like Lord Voldemort from the Harry Potter movies.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
How'd he lose his hair? From doing U-turns under the sheets?
I don't
do a Bernie debriefing, I'll tell you that right now. Or deboxering or whatever. I don't care if he goes commando. I want to get me some of that.
Yeah, okay. It's time now for a business report.
Here with that
is Megan's sister. What's the matter? Why are you rolling?
My sister. Dagging this, dagging that. Why can't you be as pretty as your sister? Why can't you be as smart as your sister? Why can't you be as vivacious as your sister?
Oh.
F my sister.
Because you're carrying 200 extra LBs, that's why.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah.
I wouldn't talk, little Miss Anorexic Maiora.
Listen, the reason that you're not coming to the house for Thanksgiving is, one, you remember the time that Mama had those new woven coasters? You thought they were Jumbo Triscuits, and you would load the dip on them. And then the next year you showed up because we gave you such a hard time and said you were with child and eating for two. And then lo and behold, September rolls around next year and you're still 60 pounds heavier. No, baby.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's all bazooms. You know that. You're just jealous. Because when Mama would take you for your training bra, they said, what could you do for this? He said, clear seal.
That's a good one. Do you have any business news, Dagan?
Yes. The woman who rests her breasts on the dinner table at Thanksgiving. That's another reason why she's not invited.
Yeah, Jonas tried to carve them.
And gentlemen, Imus in the morning.
Chris Wallace, Fox News is coming up. Water Wolf's here with sports columnist Shane Dagan McDowell. Bernard McGurk, Lou Ruffino in the house. And then also later on this morning, Laura Hillenbrand, Dice Clay, Reverend Jackson are here, Charles. I was talking earlier this morning when I signed on this morning about this biopsy that I guess I'm going to, you know, I may not even do, I haven't decided yet. Let's just see. I got to see Dr. Corvin on Monday. But because I've got these two little things on my vocal cord that they don't know what they are, but they don't think they're cancer because I had a brush biopsy about 6 months ago and it didn't reveal anything. And it could very well be, I'm a little cold now, but could very well be, just scar tissue left over from the biopsy. But then I was talking to Dr. Peekaboo yesterday.
Right.
Who's one of the finer throat specialists in the world. So I said, I said, the resonance has returned to my voice. Mm-hmm. I said, I'm a little cold now, but I said, my throat's not sore anymore. It wasn't very sore anyway, but.
Mm-hmm.
He said, well, I think you should still have the biopsy. And I said, well, what do you think it's cancer? He says, no. But we want to make sure what it is. But then he says it could be precancerous. What does that mean? He said, well, you'd have to remove them. And I said, well, what effect would that have on my voice?
Mm-hmm.
And he said, well, we'd have to talk about it. I said, well, would I be able to talk about it? Was like, my point. That's my question.
Right. Would have to type it out for you.
Because the biopsy I'm having on the 17th, if I have it, which should be 15 days from now, you can't talk for a couple of weeks. I mean, that's what they tell you. Now, I'm just hoping that they're not like most doctors who either lie or minimize what the side effects for anything, any procedure are.
Right.
They all just do for whatever reason. Either they want to get to do it so they can make the money, or they don't want to, or they don't want you to feel bad, or they just can't, like most people, they can't be truthful, mm-hmm. which is a human failing. Not one of mine, by the way, but.
Not at all.
Just for a lot of people. So anyway, so I'm just concerned about it. So I was telling Charles and these two about it, and they think it's amusing, don't you?
No, it's not amusing. But we don't want you to be unable to speak. Because then,
well, I'd have to retire. That's my point. I'm not going to go on the air. I'm not going to go on the air with a sort of and croak. I'm just not going to do it.
And I just simply suggested, I was being serious, that we could do one of those Stephen Hawking things for you. And you would be able to continue broadcasting.
Huh. All I recommended was you get that thing on your neck that you just talk like this when you have that thing on the side there.
You well, Rod, you fat bastard. I hate you.
This is just, how's this funny?
Just type it in there. Just type it in.
Sit there. You don't have to have a microphone in front of you. Just have a keyboard in front of you. Everybody say baby.
Are your peaches fuzzy?
I don't say that anymore.
Get Chamonix.
Just got an email from Neil Cavuto. Dumpster head. Shut your mouth.
Oh, God.
Oh, we can work this out. Don't worry about it.
Jesus, how fat are you?
Sorry for the news.
You two bastards, go back and write something about me.
Let me ask you this. Did anything funny get typewritten? Good morning, Warner.
Lovely guy.
Hot dog he.
Hot dog he.
That's enough. For the news. Okay.
Colby E.
Jerk Warner. Oh, God.
Hi. Headlines. Congressman Charlie Rangel will more than likely face censure today by the House for this long pattern of fundraising and financial misdeeds. He is expected to argue, though, on the floor of the House for a lesser reprimand, censure the most severe penalty short of expulsion, and require him to march down to the front of the chamber and stand there as Nancy Pelosi read the statement of condemnation against him. Tough way to go for the 40-year congressman. WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange, if you care, they now know where he is. He's in England somewhere, and police say they do know his whereabouts. A WikiLeaks spokesperson says Mr. Assange has gone into hiding because he fears for his safety, with some having called for him to get bumped off. A British newspaper reports that authorities have not moved to arrest him, even though he has landed on Interpol's most wanted list, placed on the list at the request of a Swedish court looking into sex crimes allegations against the founder of WikiLeaks.
That's too bad. Oh, man.
See, it'll work out.
All right, coming up 11 minutes after the hour here. It's good ringing from Hayes Carl, isn't it?
Oh, man, I tell you. Forget about it.
That's a great album.
Gotta be.
The album's called K Mad Yo Yo. And that Chances Are's on there. Huh. There's a couple of others. Hide Me Babes, another great song. There's some great songs on there. That's a talented. He'll be here next week.
That's looking forward to it. Certainly.
A talented dude. Nice kid, too, seemed like. But he didn't care. He doesn't have to be nice. Look at Van Morrison. He's a genius. He's not nice.
That's
nice to me, but
that's right.
Not nice to anybody else.
All you got to do is listen to his stuff.
This portion of the Adam Swain program is sponsored by the Stock Car Experience. Call 1-877-STOCK-CAR. Go online at 877-STOCK-CAR.com. All right, please welcome now to the. Is that a real cigarette?
Yeah.
How long has it been since you smoked, Charles?
Oh, 35 years, something like that.
About 15 for me, something like
yeah.
that. No, I can remember when I stopped doing dope and all. I stopped drinking. I can't remember when I stopped smoking. My wife, I wasn't married to her.
Mm-hmm. You stopped several times, as I recall.
Yeah, I stopped.
As most people do.
Yeah, I've stopped 10 times.
And I stopped 6 before it.
Years ago, over the years, I've stopped. Oh. Well, here we are.
But I'm
looking at that cigarette, and it doesn't make me want one.
No, not at all.
And it's good, then.
I've had a bottle of vodka there. Well, I wouldn't be bothered with that either. Anyway, what's on your mind this morning, Dice Clay?
Well, it's a holiday season in New York, which means the streets are jammed with tourists, all coming here to see the Rockefeller Center Christmas tree. So as my holiday gift to you, I'm going to give you some Dice advice. Stay the hell home. It's an effing tree, you follow? What are you, from some part of the world so bereft of vegetation, you got to come over here to gawk at some Norway spruce on steroids? You want to see a tree? Look out a friggin' window. Takes me 45 minutes just to go 2 blocks to get the flash dances because you morons are all jammed together like it's the black hole of Calcutta, looking up at this hedge with delusions of grandeur. What is this, Arbor Day? Ooh, look how beautiful. Take a picture, Muriel. It's so spectacular. You know what's spectacular? How stupid you people are. You come here every year to watch that idiotic parade, gape at the tree, and stand in the cold pack together like sardines to watch the ball drop on New Year's Eve. Why don't you save yourself some money? Stay in Iowa, tie yourself to the lawn furniture, and not pee for 16 hours. Then admit night, have your uncle drop a table lamp off the roof. It's pretty much the same experience. Don't you people feel bad that they cut down this thing just so they have a holiday backdrop for the Today Show? Why don't they just put some lights on Al Roker, have him stand over the skating rink? Because that's what you should be gawking at, those sweet little chicks doing double axles in them little skirts, so short you can see the... Oh!
My time for a little business news. More of it here with that. This is Dagan McDowell. Good morning, Dagan.
Can you just keep talking about Bernie's junk, please?
Oh, my God. Calm down.
What?
Oh!
Hey! What?
Do you have a business report?
Yes!
Well, give it to me.
Okay.
Except they're not saying anything.
I was just looking at you, just staring. Well, all right.
We are on the radio to you. It's hard to tell that.
Well, then, so I don't need to keep plucking the whiskers out of my face, so I'm the most feminine woman or a person around here then, which is what I was doing.
I saw you this morning with your hair up in curlers and no makeup on, so... I had a rough day already.
Poor you. All right, listen. Folks were piling into automobiles in a pretty good number last month. Ford, GM, Chrysler, Honda all reporting sales gains of more than 11%. But Toyota's sales were down 3%. Not great for Toyota. It's because folks were buying pickup trucks and SUVs. Ford F-Series, still best-selling vehicle in this country. Oh, and by the way, Dodge is bringing back the Viper, so yeehaw on that. That's all I got. You still in a bad mood?
No, I'm chewing a radish.
Oh, I'm sorry. God. I interrupted
you
your snack.
Talking about something.
I'm sorry I interrupted your snack. And I did wear brighter pink lipstick today to make sure that Connell doesn't look more like a woman than I do.
Why a rim shot of Connell?
Because you have been singing his praises like you're on the verge of inviting him over to your apartment for dinner the last 2 days.
Yeah.
Well, good
I
for
like
you,
Connell,
too.
I don't like you.
Yeah.
So that's where we're at here.
Bingo.
Well, no, I'm not sure it's about that, but
let me bring you in a cake tomorrow to celebrate your new union.
You got a bunch of your fat relatives in here smuggling, shoplifting, sheet cakes
in their
hiding in their fat rolls that are under their arms.
What he said.
30 minutes after the hour here on the island.
How do you feel now?
I feel super.
Feel like you're going to throw up?
No.
Good.
I'm all right.
I was so sick. I had 103 fever. I could barely get dressed. I'm 50 years older than you are, and I was here.
I had 112 degree fever. 112.
That's right.
I actually burst in the flame. I'm a shade darker than when I left.
Oh, no, I can't
top that. Yeah, okay.
No,
I can't.
No.
Hillenbrand, her book, Unbroken, is going to be up here in a minute. And I talked to her about that. What is it about, Bernie? Do you know?
Yeah, it's about an Olympic runner back in the 30s. And in the 40s, he was in the Army Air Force. He's shot down over the Pacific. And it's a story of survival at that point. If you like In the Heart of the Sea by Nathaniel Philbrick, which was fantastic, this book is along those lines and maybe even better.
This is the woman who wrote Seabiscuit.
Exactly, and a great writer.
Yes, and she is.
And a snappy-looking dish, too, from what I can tell looking at the pitches.
you mean an attractive woman, that's
yeah,
what you're...
Yeah, exactly.
Or should be, right?
Nothing wrong with that, is there?
No, there's not. There's certainly not.
No.
There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. And then Reverend Jackson's here. Reverend Jackson got some... he rhymes the times. We don't have time to rhyme the times now, but we will. Coming up. So what were your story? What story will he be rhyming this morning?
Oh, WikiLeaks founder, Julian Assange. He's in trouble.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You've got some rhyme for that.
And yes, I do.
And then you have a fuzzy wuzzy.
Yes, sir. Wesley Snipes is going to be in stripes.
That's, seems almost too easy. 5 minutes now until the hour. You know, I'm trying to read about, I don't know what the hell I'm reading here, about this woman's book. Something about the...
Sounds like a candidate for Linda Mood Bell.
For me?
Yeah. You can't figure out what you're reading.
Well, no, I don't know what it is. So I'm plugging your deal this morning.
Thank you.
God.
What God?
Well, no, but I mean, what's the capacity there?
Like 500?
500 people.
Yeah.
Well, how many tickets have we sold now?
Four.
We've sold 400?
No, four.
Four tickets.
It's a small but enthusiastic.
I'll be sitting at the table doing it with them. Did you do that?
You know, one time I was appearing at my own place on 52nd Street, and it was a horrible snowstorm in New York. And we sold out every night, but that night there were about 10 people there. So I sat down at the table with them. I was drinking all the time. I was drunk all the time. Not all the time, but I was drunk then. So I sat on the table and did the whole act sitting at the table drinking.
Swear with flair.
What the hell was I drinking those days? I was drinking scotch. Drinking Chivas Regal.
Oh, I remember those days.
So when I switched to vodka, that's how you know you're a real drunk. She's drinking vodka. Why that is. But, really, almost every drunk I've ever known drinks vodka. Yeah. And we got apparently some Mickey leaks going on down at the world, Disney World.
Yeah.
And here is Gangster Mickey to talk about them.
Yo, son, that's right. Forget them WikiLeaks. Here's a real story. Mickey leaks. They've just been an unauthorized release of some classified Disney documents. Everything from the blueprints of Space Mountain to the profit margin on a cotton candy to the location of Uncle Walt's frozen head. Although, unfortunately, none of these top secrets explain why Goofy a dog and Pluto a dog, but Goofy talk and walk around in his pants on his hind legs and Pluto on all fours just barking and licking himself. Or why Walt didn't draw no Johnson on me. But nonetheless, it's a security breach. There's an investigation going on trying to find out who spilled the goods, but I know it's G-Unit. Goofy, man. It wasn't a hostile action. He just stupid. He probably messing around with his laptop, stumbled into the encoded Disney mainframe, and downloaded all the classified stuff trying to get some cheat codes for the new Disney video game. You know what comes out today? Epic Mickey, the Dark Side of the Mouse. It's gonna make Call of Duty look like Ms. Pac-Man. I'm talking East Coast, West Coast, MWA, Mices with Attitude. I may be 82 years old, but I can still bust a cap in a cartoon ass. I'm the Tony Montana of the animated world. Say hello to my little friend. Bitch's name is Tinkerbell. You mess with me, you ain't gonna have no Tomorrowland. I make over $6 billion in merchandising for the Disney Corporation every damn year. $6 billion with a B. I'm Warren effing Buffett, yo. If Warren Buffett was an anthropomorphic rodent bereft of a penis. Gangsta Mizouse in the house, you better recognize, boy.
And all of these documents that were released down there. Didn't
no, there were nothing funny in them.
There weren't no funny documents.
See, like, Tony ain't here. Nothing funny.
Bernie Briefing, sponsored by PC Richardson. Great place to shop for the holidays. Good morning, Bernie.
Good morning, Chief. Well, Charles reported this yesterday. I don't think you were paying attention, but the United States Army is going to change their the way they get recruits into shape and all that. They're going to stop, according to the AP, they're going to stop five-mile runs and bayonet drills, and they're going to focus on core strength and injury prevention. And milk and juice dispensers will replace soda fountains, and whole grains will be substituted for white bread and pasta. Can you believe this? What, are they going to issue UGG boots instead of combat boots? I mean, General Patton's got to be spinning in his grave. These guys are killers. You got to, you know, get a bayonet, make them run. Don't you lose weight when you run 5 miles, Chief?
Yes.
I mean, what the hell?
Diet is important, too, and strength training is important, but to not make them run is idiotic.
It's crazy. What is this world? We have to take our country back, Chuck.
No bayonet.
Next election.
Can I take it back with you?
Yes, let's do it.
Okay, let's do this.
Yes, indeed.
I'm armed, so, you know. I mean, not now, of course. But I mean,
right. Well, right. We'll work on it.
Yeah. Yeah.
And there's Lee Harvey Oswald's coffin. Back in 1981, I believe, they exhumed him. They took him out. They made sure he was in there. And then they put him in a different coffin. This coffin that they took him out of is now it's up for auction. And the bids could go as high as $100,000. And it just seems to be, I don't know who would bid on it except somebody like John Batchelor, you know, here from WA. I could see him like
and do his show from it,
right?
I'd like to bid $10,000, please, for that.
And put it in his living room, you know, next to the TV or whatever.
Just put the coasters on top, please. Be clean.
Anyway, there's your briefing, boss.
No question that Batchelor will buy it. It's all right?
Yeah, no doubt.
23 after the hour here.
I have my hand up, please. No, I'm bidding. Right here, right here.
Time for a little business news. And with that is Dagan McDowell. Morning, Dagan.
Good morning, sir. At the bottom of the hour, we're going to get the weekly jobless claims number. It is expected to tick up from the two-year low hit last week, up 18,000. But it was still, we want it to head in the other direction. And tomorrow we get the important whole unemployment-employment report from the government. And if you have just one quick second, in defense of my kin people who might be carrying around some extra LBs, which you've been ripping on me about all morning, I just wanted to point out some people are into that. Folds and things like that.
This business report with Dagan McDowell is sponsored by the Stock Car Experience. Call 877 Stock Car online at 877stockcar.com. Kind of interesting that our thief and mafia sales department was able to sell a sponsorship for your business report, but apparently not Connell's.
Oh
boy.
Well, because you know what? I've done that stock car racing experience at Pocono.
Did you drive yourself?
Yeah. Of course, man. What kind of question is that? Yes, I drove myself.
Well, I just wondered.
You know, I wear pants in addition
to
a skirt.
No, it wasn't a...
Connell would need assistance.
It wasn't a sexist comment. I asked Tony the same thing, if he drove himself. He said, yes, he did. So
buck 60, baby. Well, I got it up to 160 miles per hour.
Tony went 170.
Yeah. No, he didn't.
Hey, what?
They don't go... there's a governor on the car. It doesn't go that fast.
I said it went 170.
Yeah. Tony said it went 170.
Damn right.
His fever was 120.
You?
Well, you know what? We'll hit the track together then, buddy.
Because you're a girl. They wouldn't let you go any faster.
Oh, they gave you the pink one.
You know what? My boot kicks the same way a man's does, I'm sure.
I'm sure it does. Who shouldn't even be allowed to watch Fox, by the way, to make him watch CNN. He says, a few days ago, your hair looked like a toilet cleaner brush that got stuck in a garbage disposal. Eat me, Steve. How does that sound? Jesus. God. I mean, you know, just don't send me any emails. I am not. You know, my job is to do this show. Your job is to either listen to it or watch it, not comment on it. I don't come to your stupid job and say to you, you know, I don't like the way you directed that plane in or whatever the hell you're doing. So, God. And I see these shows all the time. We'll take your emails. And then, you know, and they encourage you to.
Yeah.
I've seen Cavuto actually do it.
Yeah.
Encourage you mouth breathers to send them emails. Butt out. Just butt out. Let Cavuto do the show and let me do this one, and you do your job. Your job is to shut up.
Ladies and gentlemen, Imus in the morning.
I'm eating almonds now, so that's one problem. I was talking to Bigfoot Bowman about these emails that people send.
Yeah.
Which I don't like the ones. I only like the negative ones because then I can attack the people. But what is the philosophy? Because I see everybody does it. O'Reilly, he does it. Hannity does it. They all do it. They solicit these emails. Now, you know that O'Reilly and Hannity don't want to actually hear. Well, Hannity might. But, no, Hannity doesn't either.
Nah, come on.
They want to get emails from people. Well, sometimes some people can be pretty funny or interesting, but they don't ever put up. Well, they only put up emails
that are the positive.
That are positive ones. So, and occasionally they'll put up one that questions something they've done. If they have an explanation, I'm not talking about anybody specifically. I'm talking about generally people who do this, but I just don't get it. So, how many emails do we get, Bigfoot?
Probably get about 30 or 40 a day.
Well, it's not that many. It's not that many. So.
Well, it's going to rise. I mean, we just started putting them up in the last couple of weeks.
But why are we encouraging people to send them?
Well, I think anytime we get someone to say something negative about you is a good deal, don't you?
If it's amusing, if it makes me laugh, yeah.
No, some of them are good. I mean, you get enough of, hey, man, that's a great show from the people on the show. So
you're up. What's the philosophy of doing this?
Well, I think it's to get interaction with the audience and, you know,
sometimes
make them
they
feel
are
like they're involved.
Why can't they just butt out and watch it or listen to it? You think most of 80% of the people who listen to the radio in the morning, and we have enormous ratings, they're in their cars and they're thinking about something else. And so they have no more. I mean, fewer than 1% of the audience actually contacts you. Are you aware of that?
Yes.
Okay. So, and who do you think the people are who do contact you? Mental patients.
That's our audience.
Well, my point is that's not our audience. I've said that for years. The audience is not. Like, the general managers are famous for this at radio stations, TV stations, too, I suppose. Although I don't know much about television, but. Or anything. If they get one letter of complaint about something you've done, they get hysterical. Hysterical. And they think that, you know, they got to change everything.
Yeah.
Now, this is based on one letter from one listener who's got the time and the inclination to actually sit down and write a letter about something you've either said or done. No, I like the way Imus talks about the Doobie Brothers or whatever. And then so they'll say to you, you know, well, you got to be careful now. You're going to shut up, which is what I've said for years.
You know, I think we're doing too much of blank, fill in the blank. Because I got a letter that said.
Chernoff is great for this over at FAN.
Yes,
we were there. You come in, the ratings would go down. I think we're doing too much politics or not enough. I mean, it's just.
I think once in a while the interviews go a bit too long.
Yeah, exactly. Or too much country music or too much whatever.
Cut it down by half, maybe. I'm just saying maybe.
Then the ratings would go up.
And then.
What a great show today.
Yeah, so, they're unbelievable.
Can you do more of whatever?
Yeah. That was great. Laura Ingraham, that's always good. We need more of that.
Yeah. There's Chuck with the news. Morning, Chuck.